This is a guy who was very, very prolific in Israel, hence warranting the start of our show, even though I personally didn't know his work, but has a very lasting legacy.
Right. He's not so well known in North America because most of his poetry was never translated into English, but he is kind of like the national symbol. He's a national symbol in Israel because he's from the founding generation, from even before Israel was founded. He was involved in the Palmach, an elite fighting unit, which is a precursor to the IDF. And he wrote some of his first poetry right after the War of Independence, about the War of Independence. He wrote a lot of things about war, about the soldiers, about what happened to different people in Israel. And some of his poetry was turned into popular songs in Israel. Became very, very well known through that.
So it became part of pop culture, not just people that are reading poetry. So this guy actually was, he actually served in the War of Independence and in the Palmach himself.
And in the Six Day War and in the Yom Kippur War. He was, so he was very involved much in the founding of Israel. He even was sent to Europe after World War II to help bring some of the Jews back to Israel. He led some underground operations against the British in British Mandate Palestine. So a very active kind of person, and he won several prizes throughout his life, including the prestigious Bialik Award, the Israel Prize. He even was nominated for an Academy Award for a film about the Holocaust.
I know, wow, this is amazing. What a man. I mean, there's not that many of them still alive who were alive during this time, so it's like these are stories we have to capture before, you know,
94
years
old
is gone. Yeah. Wow, amazing, amazing. And you're nodding your head. Please, first of all, I want to welcome in honor of Tu B'Shvat, nearly 500,000 trees will be planted as part of a project promoting Israeli unity and hope for the future. And we have Alicia Mizrahi of the Jewish National Fund here with us. And you're doing a lot of nodding, so you're very familiar with Chaim Gori's work.
Yeah, and I think a part of what we are doing this year is a part of a bit of his legacy, talking about unity, unification of the different publics in the country. Chaim Gori was in the last years one of, you know, the last prophets that was thinking that we should go to this kind of directions and bring together all the crowds, all the color of the rainbow.
Well, I love how we are, you know, listening.